What a save!
Ottinger, are you kidding me?
This is absolute larceny.
Play the little shot, saved by Vasilevsky, and another beauty by the big cat.
Cat-like reflexes.
Haskin in front.
What a save! Bobrovsky without a stick.
Oh my gracious.
Deflected a save. Another save. Two great saves by Shesterkin. Oh man, were those beauties.
And it's taken off the line.
Oh my laundry. What a save.
And Matthews can't believe that didn't find an end.
A shot. Oh, Lincoln, a skidding save on Ekblad. Spectacular work. What a save by Keith Kincaid.
If I'm Skinner, I just skate right to the locker room.
Oh my goodness. Look at the splits of Elvis Merzlikins.
Blackwood, no! He's able to fight it off! Bruins were celebrating!
Oh, that's unbelievable!
All right, some epic stuff's there. Fun to see as all those great saves are concerned. Stu, you want to focus on UC Saros, who certainly put on a great job this week and all season.
He really has. And, I mean, for a club like Nashville, who, Dano, you and I were talking about this before the broadcast, I mean, I think a lot of us had kind of written this club out of the equation. And any time a club can kind of resurrect their campaign, insert themselves back into the playoff picture, you got to look at goaltending. Goaltending is going to be at least partially responsible. And number 74 has been all that for these Nashville Predators. One of the things I really love about the game that young UC Saros plays, he's incredibly agile. Remember, this is an undersized guy by NHL standards, but he makes up for that. The stick is very active. Watch how he's always looking in and around the net. Is there an opportunity to disrupt? And he's really, I think, among the more active just in terms of that stick in and around the puck during active play. And look at two. This is a great east-west play in front of him. Again, not a big guy, but look at the blocking surface that gets to the extreme other side and is able to fend off Helm, keep that one out of the back of the net. And this ends up being, these are just excerpts from what was really a remarkable outing for young UC, a 2-0 shutout of the Detroit Red Wings just a week back. Love how he's aggressive, takes great stock of the situation. He doesn't have anyone really in and around or behind him, so he recognizes he could be right out at the top of the paint as Larkin causes the D to break down. And again, I come back to, look at the blocking surface. He's square to it. He's down in front of it. He's not given Larkin much to look at all, and it's a quick positional save, back out of trouble, and the club is off and running the other way. This will be interesting to watch. Historically, pre-All-Star break, he has kind of tracked at a rather mediocre pace, UC Saros has, over his rather brief career to this point. But post-All-Star break, and I think we're probably, you know, by virtue of connection, getting into that space now in the NHL schedule, look to UC Saros to really bear down and look at those numbers kind of, you know, stronger, well into the 900s just in terms of the save percentage. He really seems to button his game down as the season wears on.
He's definitely stepped up. And like you guys said, if you asked me a week ago, 10 days ago, yeah, Nashville in trouble, they're going to be sellers. Instead, now they've eked back in this playoff race. Dano, for you, you're going to focus on Mackenzie Blackwood, a guy you know well.
Yeah, well, we're going to obviously take a look at save of the year candidate in a 1-0 40 save shutout effort he had yesterday against the Boston Bruins. And I talked to a pretty good goaltender today about what he thought of the save. He says it's as good as he's seen from the standpoint. There we take a first look at it. Now we're going to look at it again. And you watch, we're going to highlight the right pad. Look at his skate up and ready for that push. He's a very powerful guy with the lower body. So talking to the goaltender I mentioned, he a guy played in one of the best that played in front of him. Yeah. He says to time it, to use the flexibility, the awareness of where that puck is, and you have to be able to do it all in one motion as this puck is clearly going in. And that, again, we look at the push over the focus. To know where that puck is in the blue paint, going in the net, and not kicking it in yourself,
right,
but have the wherewithal to stretch the leg back, come across with power, and kick it out. And it was probably 99.9% over the line, as close as it gets, but a game-saving save for Mackenzie Blackwood. He has a bright future with the New Jersey Devils. Just the athleticism, the strength. He's built like a middle linebacker. He's 6'3", 225 pounds, has a lot of power in his lower body, and he needed all of it to get across and make that save. But what Marty Brodeur did tell me, he says, but to do it all together, the reflexes, the power, getting the foot back. Yeah. It all has to come together in a split second to be able to kick that puck out. That's exactly what transpired there.
Yeah.
It was pretty remarkable and no question a save of the year candidate. We've seen so many great saves this season from net miners throughout the league, but that was a beauty.
Great point, too, about not kicking, because so oftentimes guys actually kick it in the net.
Yeah.
It's moving over and just using your power to shift.
And if you notice, he pulled his leg back, like knew exactly what he was going to do all in that split second in one simultaneous motion.
It's where agility and determination and athleticism. And then the point we haven't mentioned too, Dan, and I love the breakdown, but it's like one thing to get there in front of that puck, but the strength to kind of, because he's got to kind of punch it out of the
net.
Once he does get that right leg over there, to still have the strength at the end of that stride to generate the velocity to kick that puck out. I mean, that is a dandy, an absolute dandy. And if you got somebody like Marty Brodeur singing the praises of this kid, after all, he's, kind of emulated or produced over the course of his career, that speaks volumes.
And we speak of young goaltenders going through struggles. Any goaltender, we know they're going to have ups and downs throughout their career, throughout a season. He went through his struggles after starting unbelievably for the New Jersey Devils and stealing some games. And he went through COVID. He doesn't make excuses, but I think it set him back. Right. But he looks like he's on top of his game again, because he was the difference in that game against the Boston.
More saves like that. It's great news for the Devils. When we come back here in NHL Tonight, we'll focus in on a rematch. The Islanders and the Penguins, two teams getting set to do battle. What to expect this time around? We'll break it down for you next.
Epic Stuffs are presented by Papa John's new Epic Stuffed Crust One-Topping Pizza, just $12. What pizza fans have waited for. This isn't just stuffed crust, it's Papa John's Crust Stuffed. Better ingredients, better pizza. Papa John's.